tennis ball and chomping on some cabbages while burping in between every swallow. With a hair like a snail and a body like a caterpillar, fat fluffy tail down a hollow drain, that is. Well, he asked me if I'd like to come and sit right down beside him while we introduced each other to each other.
How do you do?
I'm very well, thank you.
Lovely, would you like a spot of tea?
Oh, I'd love some, thank you. Well, his name was Mr. Snookle Fry, and there I stayed all afternoon and had my evening meal down the drain.
It was a clean drain.
Guess what we had for tea? We chewed up all the tennis balls and chomped up on some cabbages while burping in between every swallow. And the story that he told me was a story that you really ought to know, and so I'll lay it on you now.
Well, Mr. Snooklefry had not always been such a happy, friendly little fellow. In fact, he used to spend most of his time down the drain. No one ever came to see him. He had no friends, and he was very sad. It makes me sad just thinking about it. However, nearby was another little creature called a Grawb. Now, no one has ever seen a Grawb before, but Snookles told me that this little Grawb was the kindest and friendliest Grawb you could ever wish to meet. She used to watch him come out of his drain every so often at night time to collect his cabbages and tennis balls. That was his favourite food. And she noticed how lonely he was. And she decided to try and make friends with him. So, one day, she plucked up her courage and went to his drain and knocked. Not a sound. Not even a burp. She knocked again. Still nothing. Oh dear, she said. I know he's down there because I saw him go in. I wonder. I think I'll try something. And right then, she began to sing.